Our scriptures have given the greatest of respect to our, towards our parents. Pitahi dharma, pitahi karma. And the father is your religion, the father is your destiny. That is what our scriptures talk about. But there is one person in our lives about whom they put in as much importance. They say Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Deva Maheshwara, Guru Sakshat Param Brahma, Tasmai Se Guru Venama. They compare your teacher to the Holy Trinity and the universe itself. And we bow to our teachers, for it is our teachers who make us who we are. When I was a kid, I left my mom's hands, and my small hands encircled the fingers of a lady in a school called Modern School in Barakpur. And that's how my journey in life from outside my home started. When my mom decided that I'm ready to try and fly in the skies, she entrusted me to a teacher. It is a teacher who has found out the good, the bad, the ugly, not so ugly, amongst all of us, nurtured us, just as a tree needs water, needs fertilizers, needs care, needs shade. Our teachers have given all of that. They've given us the harsh sunlight when we have been truant. They've given us nurturing water when we have needed that succor. They've given us food for thought to help us nurture us. And that's how we have become who we are. Whether that be me, whether that be you, my friend, on the other side on the screen. It is an honor and a pleasure to be able to meet all of these people. And it is today my pleasure, my honor, and I dare say I do have a 56-inch ka chhati today, and I welcome one of my teachers from school to the Bong Mom's kitchen today. My teacher from school has taught me my mother tongue, Bengali. And she's a versatile lady who dabbles in dance, who dabbles in music, in crafts, and so on and so forth. Even today she teaches. She teaches people not in the school, but goes on teaching about craft. So, with utmost joy and utmost pride, I'm welcoming today my guest in the Bong Mom's kitchen, my otithi, Tultul ma'am, Banerjee ma'am, Tultul ma'am. Tultul ma'am, please come.
Yes, dear. I'm so happy.
Ma'am, it's my pleasure.
All the best. Be happy in your life, actually. And not only that, you introduced me so nicely. I must say that these children are my lifeline.
It is, like I said, when we went out to school for 6 hours a day, these are people who have been our mothers. These are people who we have worried, burdened, troubled, like we do our mothers. And these are people who have smiled, scolded us, smiled at us, encouraged us, and made us so competent that today I am able to stand in the same frame as she is. So it is.
Actually, I'm proud of you, actually.
And I'm so proud to hear that. I think that is beyond any certificate that I've got through any exam. Our schooling system is about examinations, but this certificate is way more important to me than any certificate that I've
ever
gotten.
I can tell one thing about you, that you were not at all naughty.
I guess it's her good vision that has blurred of photoshopped of all my
no.
away.
And one thing, this is for you actually.
Thank you so
maybe
much.
Maybe for you.
Okay, wonderful. This reads, Shomashri, you're amazing and wonderful. Remember that. Thank you for that. And it says, I'm so happy being the part of Shomashri's OTTs in Bong Mom's Kitchen on today's date. So that's a wonderful thing. This will now, from now on, ride here. Proud place of honor. And
thank you so much.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you so much. So, what are we cooking today?
Do you like veggie or the main fish or non-veggie? Whatever.
I'm a bong.
Yeah, bong. Then like fish, I think.
Obviously.
I like me actually.
Of course.
I also like mach bhat.
Okay.
Fish and rice only.
Right.
Today I have tried. Actually, my husband went for a operation. After that, I have to curve. Oil.
Okay.
From that time, I have introduced many things to cook without oil.
Okay.
So this is actually vetki, Bengali delicacy, that is vetki paturi.
Oh, okay.
Without oil.
Okay. So paturi comes from the word pata, I guess. We use something called vetki paturi. If you go to west and go to the Parsi community, they've got something called patrani machi, which again they do with banana leaves. So that's why the banana leaves, I guess. These are basically delicacies which are cooked using the banana leaves as a covering, and using that we do the cooking.
Yes.
Right.
Yes,
okay.
And we have, master's paste.
Okay.
And with that, I have mixed little poppy seed paste.
Okay, so posto and shorshe,
both
of them
are there.
So, East Bengal, West Bengal, punch together. Okay, wonderful.
And this is
salt. That's haldi.
Haldi.
Turmeric.
Chili.
Green chili.
And some,
to bind it up,
bind.
I guess.
Not the bind, actually. Yes.
Yeah,
to
hold it in place.
Hold it.
Right.
And
you've got
else.
Banana leaves.
Yeah.
So you've got this is fillet of which fish?
Actually, this is not the fillet of vetki. I have brought today the basa.
Basa.
Basa,
okay.
Is very commonly. We get it in
across the country.
Yeah.
So anybody who is outside, in you are from the west also or from south, you can easily take a basa fillet and do it. Basically, it's a seafood. Bhetki is also a seafood. We call it bhetki. It's actually bhetki. It is a seafood, so what will come is it. The fillets come out very, very well. So for a basa also, you get the fillet very well. If I take it up, and you will see here that it is. I think you already marinated it.
Marinated with lemon.
Okay.
And salt.
Okay, and overnight?
Not overnight, okay. Only 20 minutes actually.
20 minutes 20 of marinade.
Minutes.
Okay, 20 minutes of
marinade. Hardly take time.
So you will see, so what happens is it will also make it softer,
yeah,
the marination. And because it's a seafood, what happens is the lime goes in that much more quicker in the salty water environment that it has had. Yeah, the salt will also rarefy it and it will go in that much more easier and quicker, making it softer while we are cooking. Right, so
and
wonderful.
Not only that, marination needed because some of them cannot have take this seafood because of a little smell.
Okay, so it
and
will
it
also take
also.
Off the, take off the smell also, right? Wonderful, wonderful.
It goes also.
Yes, yes, that's a wonderful thing.
And
to
it
read.
Also make firm.
Okay.
It make firms also.
Okay, fair enough. So how do we go about it now?
Now can I start?
Sure.
I'll do it in the microwave, okay?
Okay.
Already I have made two. I'm just keeping it here.
Okay.
So these two.
So how much did you take, ma'am, if you don't mind me asking?
No. Just not much actually.
For this portion of two, how much mustard and how much poppy?
Just
mustard
paste. One teaspoon mustard.
Okay.
And then you paste it.
Okay.
And half teaspoon.
When you were making the paste, did you add mustard oil?
No, not at all.
Not at all.
Not at
so
all.
These are just wet paste.
Without oil.
These are wet paste.
Wet paste.
Just wet paste. So 1 teaspoon of mustard paste.
Mustard paste and half.
Half of the post, the poppy paste.
For these two.
Okay.
Now I'll wrap it.
Are you adding a little bit of this haldi also?
Haldi also. I'll put. Otherwise it will look white. I know the color also.
Matters.
I'll not put any kind of this mustard oil.
Oil. Okay.
Yes, it's without oil. Now I'll put it. Oh no, it's later I'll do it. Already I have
greased it. With mustard oil. Okay.
Otherwise it can be break.
It'll stick.
Yeah,
it'll
that's
not come
why.
Out.
This thing, I'll put one, this is for decoration. I love, very hot, that's why I'll...
If you want more, you can add one more, depending on taste.
Yes.
So if anybody wants to make it hotter, probably while making the mustard paste, they can also grind it with a little bit of green chili.
It's important. Otherwise, the mustard seeds become, some bitter.
Bitter. So you need a little. So you did add a little bit of green chili while making it.
Yes, while pasting.
These ornaments that you're wearing are wonderful, ma'am.
Which one? This
the one you're wearing?
Oh, made by me.
Yeah.
These are my passion right now.
Yeah, you told me.
Have you seen my earring?
Yeah, I have seen it. I'm seeing it up close and personal. Right.
Not
so we'll talk. We'll
just see my sari.
Wonderful.
Done by me.
This is also done by you?
This is an old sari actually.
Okay,
I colored
you.
It and made it.
Wonderful. So we'll talk about this once we've put this into the micro, right?
Yeah.
When did you leave school, ma'am?
2 years back.
So that's in
2 years back, but now
in 2017.
I'm enjoying my life like anything.
Retired life. Not missing those naughty people like me.
I'm missing those people, but social media
has helped to keep in touch.
Just as we have been in touch. And the social media, I'm very thankful to social media.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
Everybody talks about. The evils of social media, you are one who's saying it's not evil, right?
No, not evil for me. It's really a great friend.
Okay, we'll just do this or we'll
this
add
up. Close it.
Okay.
It is 100% power.
Yeah.
And 2 minutes. It depends how much time you will do. It depends on the quantity. Right. If it's 6-7... give it more, two or three minutes. At home in my party actually, while I do these things, I make it 5 minutes because of 10.
So now tell me, ma'am, what have you been up to about your crafts and stuff? I know you are passionate about crafts. I know you used to teach people how to dance during the annual days, of which I've never been part of, unfortunately. And then I do remember you singing also.
No, my Shomasri, I'll do one thing. You are just feeling sad that you could not take part in school.
No, I'm not.
No, I'm not. I'll take you now.
I'll make you dance. No, I can't dance. That's something that I cannot do. Dance is something which is not my cup of tea.
I'll make you dance, I tell you.
Ma'am, please, ma'am, you tell me. If you ask me to dance, the dance floor will break.
You can't shake your body, I think.
Ma'am, the dance floor will break. Everybody will run away. Don't ask me to dance or to sing. You tell me to do some other stuff, I will do that. As long as you keep my mouth running, that's fine. But you don't ask me to sing or don't ask me to dance.
That is proving now. That's proving now, actually.
I guess I don't miss.
Actually, Shomusri, in the class, you are very quiet, very gentle. Now also you are gentle.
I'm glad to hear that part, at least.
But still, I must say, you were not talkative that time. You are not talkative right now too, but still you can continuously talk.
Well, she's a ma'am, she's not the mom. There's an A instead of the O. That's why she's saying talkative, because my mom will say that chup hone ke liye kitna lega. So, I don't know, because it's because you're an A and not an O. Anyways, it's good to know that I'm not talkative.
No, we are not talkative. We are talking in sense, but you can talk. I mean, longer time, continuously, without any sleep. That's amazing.
No, the point is, right now I have become a salesperson, and after all, a salesperson, papi pet chalta hai baaton se. So we cannot do anything about without not talking, ma'am. This is just a passion, and thankfully this passion is also making me talk. Wonderful. I think we are through with this. Shall we check
done.
And turn? Burst of flavors coming out. There's a musty odor of the banana having got steamed
right,
in it.
Right.
And I'm also getting the strong kicky smell of the mustard paste coming in. The poppy seed paste smell I'm not getting.
No, poppy seed smell, it's because the quantity is very less.
Yes, I'm also getting a very faint whiff of a fishy smell, the pungent smell of fish, that is sea fish, right?
Sea fish, right.
Wonderful. So let's get this out.
While you were calling your guest were waiting in the table.
Okay.
That time you can put it.
And it will be ready.
Take something.
And it will be ready.
Such a quick.
Wonderful, actually. If you are giving it as a starter, for example,
it
can be made ready in this. But traditional, this also goes with rice. So if you have already called in your guests, given them the starters, while the table is being set, all you can do is you can just get this thing done in a jiffy.
Right.
So are we ready here?
It's ready. Can I open?
Right. Of course, the toothpick, and oopsie
daisy. I don't know how it has come.
The smell that is coming out, what we'll do is, we'll do this now, and then we'll just
give you focus.
Wonderful. So what we here have is that the mustard paste has got wet a little bit because of the steam that has been generated, and it has gone into the fish, is what I'm expecting it to when I go and start and eat it. Now what I'll do is I'll move the chili a little bit here for now, and there it goes in. So you can see that because the marination was done wonderfully, it is cut into the flesh just like hot knife into butter. So what I'll do is here, I'll take it off like this and expose the fish. So this side I've got the paste, this side I've got the fish in. Wonderful.
Oh dear.
What happens is my tongue is aflame right now with the taste of the mustard. Let me get some more and check it out. And it has gone into it, the flavors have started to go into it. So what you have is an outer basting of the spices and just enough going into deep into the flesh, so that when your taste bud touches the inner side also, then also you get some flavors. Now if you go and eat this with a little bit of rice, what will happen is it will get diffused with the rice, and you can have it wonderfully with this. Because I'm having it just like this, what is happening is I'm being overwhelmed by the taste of the mustard, which in itself as a standalone is wonderful. And if you like it hot like ma'am, what you need to do is wonderful.
Actually, this is without oil. That is a point also.
Wonderful. And that what you can see is here that the water from the steam, the fish was good. So the water has just come out from the steaming, and this is what has gone and made this paste. And because of this, This has seeped into the fish flesh and made it all the more wonderful. I just can't stop.
And Shomo, I just want to mention one thing, that if the timing is much, you just give it more time, it will dry and it will.
So you cannot do it, overdo it.
Yeah, overdo it. That is very important. And nothing is very, difficult here. It's so easy to make.
I only wish, ma'am, that when I was in school, Bengali was a little bit easier than this. I'm scared to remind you what my score was in class 10. It was just 49.
You were in the tough time, actually. That was a tough time. Nowadays, 90% also getting in Bengali. Do you understand?
Does it mean that we studied harder and these people are studying lesser?
I don't know, but that time was much, much better, I must say. And this time, they cannot speak Bengali properly. They mix with English and also in Hindi. But still, they are getting good marks.
Only we can still say Chitta Jetha Bharshana Uchcha Jetha Shir. Gyan Jetha Mukta Jetha Griher Prachir Apun Prangon Tale.
Who said that you are not good in Bengali?
I never said I'm not good in Bengali. My marks just reflect that I was not good in Bengali.
No, I never believed in marks.
Thankfully, ma'am. So this is wonderful. And most importantly, I just can't stop licking my fingers out of it. Most importantly, what happens here is this. Ki because it's sea fish, you've got omega fatty acids in it. So it's healthy for you. There's no oil, so that's why it again is healthy for you. The mustard and the poppy seed mix will give you that wonderful taste. And the way the mama has made it, quick fix. So, I just wish ma'am had given us some such quick fix ways to get more marks in school, but then then it was hard work gets you the way, porashuno kore jei jon gari kora chore sei jon, and all of the stuff. But then this is a wonderful dish. It's a very traditional dish in Bengal. Just to recapitulate, what we did is we took 1 teaspoon of mustard paste, half of poppy seed paste. While you made the mustard paste, what you did is that you grounded with a little bit of green chilies. And you did ensure that there was no oil in that.
No.
Then we marinated the fish for about 20-25 minutes with just lemon and salt. Mm. And then covered the paste on the fish,
and also I applied little haldi oil.
Leaf. So we added a little bit of turmeric in the paste. Then we took a banana leaf, greased it with just a little bit of mustard oil, because the mustard oil gives you the zing, and then put the fish in, wrapped it, used a toothpick to hold it in place. And then we put it in the micro for 2 minutes only.
2 minutes, 100% power.
Full heat.
Full heat.
So that's the easiest thing to do. And if you're a foodie or a bong foodie and a fishy like all of us here, that's the best way to do it. And the best part about all of this is that it's her who is doing it with me. So wonderful, ma'am. Thank you so much for this wonderful dish. And more importantly, thank you for this card, this memory of mine, and for having me in your memory also, which is most important.
So, thank you very much. It's my pleasure.
It's all my pleasure. Thank you so much. Thank you for coming. If you liked all this that we are doing here, that we keep doing here in the Bong Mom's Kitchen, not just today, you need to share the joy. You need to go down to our details. They need to like.
Of course.
They need to share and tell it to all of us, all about it. If you want to be on this side of the camera like her, then you need to just write on the comment box with your details and we'll come back to you. Till we meet next time, go back to your school, go back to your teachers, whether you made a good mark, whether you did not. Hug them like this. Hug them. get their love. Get their love like nobody else can give you. Just like only your mother can give you. You will have your sirs also, who will be your surrogate fathers. These are the surrogate mothers. And remember, you are you because of people like them. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Shomo.
Pleasure.